Just cross our fingers. We are on. Well, good evening. Okay. Today I want to have a little go at painting nothing. Specifically, the space. That's going to be important to this picture. Actually, Some kind of jug, anyway. I've got a single light source, and that should produce quite a nice effect. I've got a dark background. That dark background is very important. The canvas today is primed with Michael Harding non-absorbent acrylic primer with some ink. And it really does work. The oil doesn't sink into it at all. So I'm not going to have a great deal of opportunity to build layers. We're going to be pretty much on layer. Dark is the most important thing. Not quite black, but it's pretty close to it. So I'm going to try and treat the background as a subject just as much as the foreground, rather than do a background and stick a jug in. Trying to get the whole first thing I'm going to need. I'll reload the palette as I go along. I might be proper cheeky and use some black. I can't find any. I won't do something else. Yeah, no, I have to mix my own. And every, even something which is pretty close to black still has a colour. So, I'm going to try and identify it and mix it as I go along. And it's quite bluey in the background there. Missing colours now. Upstairs in a no, not upstairs. Ah, that's an ultramarine. I'll have more of that today. Clear out, yeah. Choice of blues. Move out. orange. You never know when they might be useful.
It creates a bit of luminosity.
I think I'm going to use more than one blue. This. A little bit of Prussian. Start with. Bit of this. Like that. Oh. You, the viewer, have the advantage of polarized filters, getting rid of any shine. Now, working. That way again. I don't have that, so I'm having to sort of see around this colour. And even just from a little, little glints of light coming from this, I can see it's on the bluey side, so if I've got. Be able to see where that hue lies, and feels pretty good to me. I guess that's the start of my grey in the background. I'm going to leave some there. In fact, it's drawing in for you. Composition wise, I want this to be a space. Quite important. Back. Doing my Mondrian thing now. I like that space. I like the fact that you can square behind. Right. Then I think write that up. Sort of shape. I like that. That's good. This stuff. Yeah. Okay, is that enough drawing? Let's see what else I want to do. Shapes. personality. Throw over there, but anyway. So if I'm looking for tonal contrast to start with, back here. I want to see the tonal jump. It's way behind. It's my shadow colour. So this can mix in with any colours I put on top. I don't, this doesn't have to be finished colour by no means. But I'll keep all this fairly vague, you know. That's very dark too. Bit of the tonal balancing already. Now, good thing about sealed side surface, that I can take stuff away and store. Look at that shape, it's telling me something about the shape. Change scale as it goes along. That pretty much looks like the tonal jump. I'm not going to do all the creases in the fabric and stuff, they're not that important to me. I can see the shape of the nothing. Okay. I don't want to get hung up on the drawing stage. Very boring videos. Boring videos. Sorted. Okay, I was quite enjoying the way it was carved up. I think I might tile these spaces in. A few little drawing checks. So from the point of view of this, yeah, I'm trying to find the angle of this. Generally, it points to the other corner. This occurs out quite quickly. That starts off pointing at that corner. Pretty much. Face. That's the shape. That actually. Just that. follow the bottom of the handling. Roughly in the middle, which is the right of it. Okay, so this has now become the beginning part. So that handle's going to go up there. Also use a clean brush with a bit of thinner on it. Right. About it. Doing it here. Camera. That's just beyond. Svelte over there. Pretty good. Spout. Into that area of light comes in a bit. That's all the fiddling in. That's good. Cool. I think I've got the personality of that job now. What I'm going to do, same thing I did when I was very much trying to avoid it. I've got the tonal jump, I'm happy with that. So when I put white in, just as a starting tone, you'll be able to see that. Good, we're going to need a pile of paint. Area covered. But it's just three of us. Four of you can do doing these rounds. They are quite comfortable. Matches. This setting steel surface, this is a sink in or removable. So I'm working that as well. Maybe the colour is a little bit darker. I'll bring some colours in up. But I want to get the subtle colours of it. Okay. Okay.
suitably rough.
There was something I was approaching last week when I was getting scales. Good. Dark enough. Perhaps. Too literal. That's a funny. Brush. Been waiting for an excuse to use this. Chuck some oil on it as well. water. Bit. Green. Blue. Yeah, do face. Do that. Think. Too much better shapes. More. Of that canvas.
enough stuff. Guessing. Well, I've got a perfectly good clock on shifter, which is exactly what. So, these are two to straight up. Working France. Launch the eye in. Right, your background on. I'm going to be brushing the clean. Have a short break. Come back for two in a moment. Finish this off. Key thing to do: mix the right colours, apply them efficiently, simply as possible. Give that a go. Simplest, biggest strokes. Mixed the colour for the dark, but I didn't mix the colour for the light. That's going to be crucial. It's quite a white light. Quite a bit of warmth. Thank you. Brushes. This white, it's a bit mucky. Subconsciously thought on. Oh, yes, very different. I'm ready to go to a lighter but it was question. This is where. comps team is the most Browns at the top. One of the incessant fiddling. Hey. Okay. Oh yeah. Right.
that what?
It's mostly not what I'd be saying. Okay. That's pretty much there. Oh, hi Jason. brush. Highlight. Do I do a softer one first, then? James. Shape. Begin. Take that joke. Now, write this in the middle. Yes, yeah, so I'm spotting all sorts of places that goes. Still going to go back to very dark. but last highlights. And move like this. That's away. Bright highlights go on top. Sorry. There's another kind of thing. There isn't really any on the rest of the jack. I like time. Going all the way to one. Wow. Yeah, I'm trying to do that. Another picture about. I don't mind. I'm alright with that. Oh, now I'm starting to see how little things. Yeah, I had that pale orange. Okay. Anyway, that will do for that. Thank you very much for joining me. And I hope you'll join me again. In the meantime, straight on the look of it. Just on my fingertip. Shows up okay. Oh, the camera seems to have moved itself. Super. Thanks everyone for joining, and I will post a picture of this. I'm going to start eBaying these. So you could pick one up for as little as 99p. you can't get them cheaper than that. I think that's the lowest price, so whoever paid it, but there you go. Not including postage, obviously. Because I can't keep them all. And well, there's some good ones to keep to one side. It'd be nice to sort of share them out. And also have different sort of tiers of the work I do, so there's the stuff which is going to be exhibited, and the stuff which is explained to join next stuff. But there's plenty which is just going to end up in racks, which has been interesting enough to do, but doesn't have any life beyond that. So it'd be nice if it did. Normally, it relies on someone coming to an open studio and rooting through the racks. Like to do so, might put a section like that on the website as well. Have these up for each, and pop them on eBay into maybe bargain. So yeah, let me know if there's a particular thing you'd like to see on eBay for 99p, and I may well be happy to oblige. Just further the experiments. So thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next week.